away. So there's less and less people that know that there is a rest of the world. But a little birdie been telling us about some shit going down around here.
Yeah, big shit.
Feeling you.
Yeah.
And I gotta say, your recent election was heartening.
Shit.
All of the people of the globe that need inspiration from wherever they can get it, that we're gonna turn this around, you know? I think together we can touch their asses, you know? I was talking to some lovely people this afternoon about the Schulman resonance. Have you guys heard about this? Schulman resonance? Well, you have, because it's the fucking heartbeat of the earth that Mr. Schulman over there in Germany really quantified for the first time. And it resonates with our brain activity, as in our consciousness is the earth's consciousness. And okay, I'm going to talk out my ass for a minute here, but I'm telling you, look it up, and get it, correct me, because I know I'm wrong, but I think I'm also right. So this Schulman resonance has been measured at a certain level. It kind of holds steady, like 7.8 hertz, right, for a long time. And about last January, shit changed. That's scientific, I know, that might be over your head. Some shit went down. And this is now being registered at 36 hertz, which is just about where an 808 goes. That's about what we can hear, not only feel. There's a great spike in human consciousness that's occurring. People believe in it. I know there's a lot of darkness, there's a lot of regression, but the flip side is us, and we're coming awake, and we can turn this around. So I want to give you this poem that's up out of America, out of my mouth in particular, but I think that it is about all of us, really. I love my country, by which I mean I'm indebted joyfully to all the people throughout its history who have fought the government to make right, where so many cunning sons and daughters, our foremothers and forefathers, came singing through slaughter, came through hell and high water so that we could stand here and behold breathlessly the sight, how a raging river of tears cut a Grand Canyon like. I've been a few places now, flown through vast empty spaces with stewardesses whose hands look much older than their faces, and I've tossed so many napkins into that big hole in the sky. I've been at the bottom of the Atlantic, seething in a two-ply, looking up through all that water and the fishes just swimming by. And I don't always feel lucky, but I'm smart enough to try. 'Cause humility has buoyancy, and above us only sky. I lean in, breathe deeper that brutal burning smell that surrounds the smoldering wreckage that I've come to love so well. Yes, color me stunned and dazzled by all the red, white, and blue flashing lights in the American intersection where black crashed head on with white. Comes a melody, comes a rhythm, a particular resonance that is us. and only us. Comes a screaming ambulance and a hand that you can't trust, laid steady on your chest, working for the better good, which is good at its best. And two, bearing witness, like a woman bears a child with all her might, born of the greatest pain, into a grand canyon of life. Because no song has gone unsung here, and this joint is strung crazy tight, and people have been raising up their voices since it just ain't been right. With all the righteous rage and all the bitter spite that will accompany us out of this long night, that will grab us by the hand when we are ready to take flight, seat back and tray table in the upright and locked position, shocked to tears by each new vision of all that my ancestors have done. For instance, the women who gave their lives so that I could have one. Born into ground zero of the feminist revolution. It was an inside job, stoic and sly, one we're supposed to forget and downplay and deny. But I think the time is nothing, if not now, to let the truth out. Coolest F word ever deserves a fucking shout. I mean, why don't all decent men and women call themselves feminists? The belief that women should have rights and opportunities equal to those of men. Why don't we call ourselves feminists? If only out of respect for those who fought for this. I mean, look around. We have this. Yes, I love my country, by which I mean I'm indebted joyfully to all the people throughout its history who have fought the government to make right, where so many cunning sons and daughters, our foremothers and forefathers, came singing through slaughter. Came through hell and high water so that we could stand here and behold breathlessly the sight how a raging river of tears is cutting a grand canyon.